Well, I am in a North Denver rail yard waiting to catch out after my train I thought was Chicago bound turned out to be a Denver train. One of the drawbacks when you don't know what you're doing. But anyway, I'm hoping to catch out of here first thing in the morning for Chicago. And so I'm just hidden away, biding my time. Gonna get comfortable for a few hours and we'll see what happens. You feel a little vulnerable in the middle of a, you know, big city rail yard kind of thing at night, you know, but oh well. You gotta do what you gotta do to get out of here, right? Well, I think we're getting ready to roll out of Denver. But I've thought that before. Well, the train is moving, which is a good thing. Hiding from the sun because, man, I got burned yesterday. Better stay down for a while, yeah. And at this altitude, that sun packs a punch. Solution is at hand, and rolling on we are. I'm not sure if we'll make Chicago today yet. This is single track, so a lot more stopping than the double track main lines, but it's still, you know, still main line. And, we'll clip right along through Nebraska here shortly. I'm getting a phone call, probably from my beautiful spouse.
swapping places with this, our counterpart coming from Chicago.
Thank you.
lot for a Jeep, right? It's a kill. I'm pretty far up the train, so I gotta be quiet. Be careful. This is probably where the crews park their cars.
Thank you. cover, you know, or ready to meet customers. But so far, I haven't needed to. We'll see when we stop if maybe, you know, that makes a difference or something. But right now, this is working pretty well. And I don't think this rain is the kind of deal that's going to go on all the way to Chicago. You know, knock on wood. I hope not. Definitely out of the arid part of the country now. Everything's lush and green. Life is exploding. I always look at these fields because there's a lot of times turkeys.
Some rain on me, so I've got my rain jacket on and I'm gonna put the camera away and keep it covered, but we stopped outside the yard, so I was able to hop right off and I grabbed my knife. I can't believe I retrieved two things I dropped down there, a flashlight and a knife. The flashlight got caught on one of these door handles, you know, one of the latches on the container door, so I could just reach it and grab it. But that's the drawback to these containers. There's 5 or 6 inches of space there for stuff to fall down. And it's hard to get back up out of there. It's probably 4 foot down to the bottom. Anyway, I'm going to put this all away and hopefully we'll get rolling so that we can stay dry here.
Omaha, or we could take a bypass south of there and
just never know which way they're going to route things. Most of the time you go south, so we probably won't actually be going through the city of Omaha. I kind of hope we do, but, you know, it's doubtful. We'll see what we see when we get there.
How far, but I think we got a ways to go.
slowed down for some reason. And I'm hoping that Willow Springs isn't all jacked up. Well, there's why we're slowing down. We got a 40 mile an hour curve. Right as I get up the video a little bit, we go through an intersection. We're just rolling into Joliet.